Okay, we're here at the drawing table, and I'm getting ready to show you guys how to do some caricatures. First of all, I'm going to show you what materials I'm using. Right now I'm using a Crayola marker. These are fairly inexpensive. It's a very useful tool for caricature art because you have a conical tip. So you can get some really good, like, fat to thin lines with these. They're really inexpensive. Buy them in bulk. And you can find them online. I'm also going to be using another thing here made by Crayola called a color stick. They used to make these, I think, through Prismacolor, but they've been discontinued. So I found that this is a really suitable alternative to that. These are great for adding values and tones at the end. So you can have not just a black and white outline, but also some gradation in there to show some volume. So what we're going to be drawing today is the family. Good friends of mine called the Schroeders. They're a family of four. And I'm going to be doing each individual family member separately today. So, without further ado, I'm going to get started. And the first person I'm going to draw is a little girl named Jessie. So we're going to start out with Jessie. So the first time when I do a caricature, I always try to get the name first. Just so that way, it's just a way to get ink on the paper real quick, but it's also so that way I don't screw the name up. I get it out of the way early, and if I have to ask, you know, for a correct spelling, I always do it at the beginning. I've known this little girl for a little while, so I've known how to spell her name. So we're going to get started here, and I'm going to have Jessie's picture over here. I'm going to place that so then that way you can kind of see her picture while I'm drawing, and we're going to go ahead and do that for each individual piece. So I'm going to get started here. We're going to draw this little girl. All right. So the first thing I like to do is I like to basically just get the outline of the shape of the head and the shoulders. For this, we're going to be doing just like head and shoulders kind of a shot for the caricature. So, yeah. It doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to kind of somewhat be a good facsimile of the shape of the head. So I'm going to start out here with her jawline and the like top of her head, her hairline. Okay, so we start out there. I always try to get the ears, the shape of the head, and then like a really quick representation of the neck. And then maybe like a collar, the shirt they might be wearing. I always like to draw nice swooping lines for the hair. And I always like working on big paper. That's another thing I forgot to tell you guys about what kind of paper I'm using. I'm using a hammer mill 12 by 18. It can be found usually online. There's some retail places that will carry it, but I really like using the 12 by 18. It's just a good size. I can get some good swooping lines with the size of paper that I'm using right now that you're seeing. And I really enjoy using it. Somebody turned me on to it years ago, and I've been using it ever since. It's served me well. I buy it by the ream, and I use it in a lot of my gigs when I travel. If I'm working on site, this is the paper of choice. So, hammer mill 12x18. These are very nice people. I enjoy hanging out with them. I'll draw some freckles here. Yeah. So, yeah, that might just about do it. Caricatures usually take about anywhere from, for me anyway, they usually take anywhere from 5 to 6 minutes. Trying to get a little bit faster. I think the key is to try to get them done as quickly as possible, especially if you're working at a party event. I mean, really, ultimately, like, the true goal is to get the likeness. So if it takes a little bit extra time, that's okay. All right. So we've got her done. And I'm going to go ahead and add some value with the art stick. I'm putting down the Crayola marker. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to add some tone to this. Really make it pop. Okay, so what I like to do is I like to add some tone above the eyes. can see on the cheeks. It's always good. Under the mouth here, maybe sometimes under the nose. Anywhere you look like there's going to be a shelf where there's light coming down, and then there's something that's going to be like blocking that light, like the bottom of a nose, under an eyebrow, under a lip. As you can see, I've already put a little bit down here with a black marker for the neck. Inside of the ear is always a good spot for that. In here. And then, yeah, we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit more. And you don't wanna get too dark with this. You kinda wanna just add it lightly. And then that way you can always build up if you need to. Less is more here. Yeah. This is a fair-skinned little blue-eyed girl. So we're gonna wanna leave the eyes kind of light there. And what we can do now is we can add a little bit of streaks to the hair. Yeah, like I always try to leave some light at the top, but then add some darks along the sides, maybe in the back, behind the ears. I always try to go a little bit darker. Yeah. And then the light's coming this way. There's gonna be shadow over here. And we're gonna add that with this Crayola art stick. Actually not art stick, color stick. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we can even put a little bit in here, very lightly, the teeth. Yeah. The trick is with kids, you don't want to add a whole lot of line to the face because then that indicates wrinkles, which indicates age. We want to keep it looking fairly young. So yeah, that's about all I'm going to do with little Jesse here. I might add some curls in the hair. It's okay to add some curls into the hair. Yeah. There we go. There it is. Yep. And I might even put in a hand here. There we go. And then I always like to put maybe a little bit of a banner or some kind of border. And I just make it really quick. And there you have it. You got your little caricature done. I might just go ahead and put a little bit of extra black in there just to kind of add some fill in the background. Yeah. Done. Okay, we're gonna move on to the next one. The next one I'm going to do is going to be Jesse's big brother, Dorian. Okay, so we're going to get started with Dorian here. Okay, and I'm going to put a picture of Dorian again to the left of us. Okay. G-O-R-I-A-N. We'll sign it. Again, putting the name in first and foremost. Okay. So we're going to start out with Dorian here. Again, we're going to start out with the contour of the head with the hair. So there's Dorian, some ears there, and then we're going to draw the jawline here, Dorian, and then we're going to add a neck, and then a quick little couple of wispy lines for the indication of a collar, okay, and then his jaw. Or chin, as it were. Okay, I'm gonna fill this out here. Give him such a pointy jaw. We're gonna. There it is. Always line up the nose with the base, or actually the bottom of the earlobes. It's always a good spot. Good thing to do is just kind of study the subject's face for a few minutes or for even just a few seconds. As you get better, it won't take so long. You can just kind of give it a good glance and you can say, okay, I know where this kid's features are going to be, or whatever subject. Doesn't matter if it's a child or if it's an adult. Okay. So we pretty much got everything we need here from Dorian, with the exception of his glasses, and I always do the glasses last. And I always do is I put like the little bridge of the glasses over the nose. Gives me a good indication of where the lenses can be planted. It's like an anchor point for me. And then I just do some quick wispy lines. Doesn't have to be perfect, but you do want them to be somewhat equidistant and you want them to be somewhat similar in size. You don't want like one small, one large. I don't spend too much time worrying about, you know, how big they are, how little they are. As long as they're somewhat similar in size, we just get that done, move on ahead, and move to the next stage, which is going to be our good old crayon. Now, as you can see in the picture over here, Dorian is a redhead, so which means we don't want to go too dark with his hair. We just kind of want to add some light indication that he's got some value in his hair. That there's a hue of some sort in there, because we're using black and white here. Yeah, we're just going to add a little bit of black in here as an indicator. Yeah. Okay. We're going to put a little bit of shadow under his eyebrow. Like this. And then some tone in his cheeks. And then we're going to just finish this one out. Yeah. You can even rub it with your finger if you want. And I think that'll do. Dorian is done. You can add some shoulders to him, or you can just leave it as a collar. It just depends. I do both. So. And then I usually connect my borders with the shoulder. Ties it all together. Makes it look nice. Yeah. And then I can go ahead and just kind of add very gently some tone to the background. And I might put a couple freckles in there on Dorian. I do recall he has a few. There it is. All right, we're going to move on to the next piece, which is going to be Mom, and her name is Lindsay. I've known Lindsay for a long time. First time I met her was when I was working at a frame shop, and she's a local artist. So she would come in and get her stuff framed. Her most striking feature is her kooky cat eye glasses, which I've always loved. And she still wears them to this day, which I think is very endearing. So I'm going to draw her, and we're going to have a picture right here. Or at least we should. Okay. And Lindsay is mom to Dorian and Jesse. And we're going to try to put in her bandana here. Lindsay definitely has that Lucille and Ball thing going on. So we're going to try to capture a little bit of that. And her curly red hair. Okay, there we are. Okay. All right. was to get the shape of the face, the draw line. Alright, so we've got a good portion of this caricature done. We get those distinct eyebrows. Alright, and then at this point, she's so funny. Let's see here. Got some curls coming off the back of her neckline. There we go. Some pupils. All right. Now we're getting somewhere. And last but not least, those crazy, kooky glasses. Yeah. I think there's a little and Lindsay is also an artist, so I think I'm gonna incorporate a little bit of that into this too. Maybe have her hand here. Like maybe holding a pencil or maybe a paintbrush. She loves to paint, so let's go ahead and put a paintbrush in her hand. There we go. Another border. And I don't think this one needs much as far as tone. I'm going to put a little bit of some dark in her shirt here. Maybe in her bandana. Actually, let's go ahead and throw some paisleys in there. Let's see here. We're not going to go too overboard with these, but you know, just enough to get the idea. Maybe a little right there. All right, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to add some tone in here real quick. Yeah, there we are. And then maybe some wisps for her red hair. Okay, we're getting close to the end here. I might put a little bit here in her eyebrows, under her eyebrows. Okay. A little bit here in her lips. Yeah, like this. And then maybe some in her ear. Yep, I like it. And maybe like a little indication of a chin. And we're done there. Maybe put a little bit here on the paintbrush. All right. We're getting there. Maybe a little bit here in the for the tongue. And that's it. And last but not least, we're going to do Dad. It is Clayton. All right. Clayton will be over here, depicted in a picture. As long as I've known Clayton, he's always had slicked back hair. So I think at one time he had kind of like a pompadour or some form of haircut that had some body to it, but for the most part nowadays he just ties it in a ponytail or he slicks it back. Either way, it makes for a great caricature. Okay. Go right for those eyebrows. And as you can see, like, he's got some serious mutton chops, which we're going to try to represent here. Now, people have darker eyes, like browns. I just tend to fill those in black. It just saves on time. That's kind of a shorthand that I have. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go right to the mouth at this point. We're going to go ahead and just draw that smile. Not going to mess with the mustache or any of the facial hair just yet. We're just going to want to try to get the position of the mouth first. And then there we go. And then from there, we can kind of go in and feel it. And I'm just going to go ahead and just fill this in with black marker. I'm not even going to mess with the color stick. We're going to go ahead and use up some of this ink in this pen. I like that. And I think what we're going to do here too is we're going to go ahead and just kind of probably fill some of these sideburns in as well. And we're getting really close to being done. Looks like Clayton's got some circles under his eyes being a dad, I'm sure. A lot of dads can relate to that. I'm going to fill in maybe a little bit more of the mustache under the nose. Now we're talking. We're getting really close here. And voila, there it is. Very good. Put a little bit of. Yeah. And there you have it. Border. And we are done. Actually, I might put a little bit up here just to finish this off. Indicate he's got some color, some value in his hair. I think that would do. That way he doesn't look like he's going gray on top. Wouldn't want to misrepresent that. And there it is. Ta-da. All right, if you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe. We'll see you next time. I'll have another project ready to go. And if you have any questions or queries, just put them in the comments below. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time on the